Recognized as the senator from the 18th.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon now, colleagues. I had not intended on speaking, but with what we've heard this morning, I feel compelled to address this body as the Pro Tem. You know, there's an old expression, there's a time and place for everything, but I think I've just learned there's not a time and a place for everything. And this well is a sacred place that under our rules and the way we conduct ourselves, you'd come down here and express yourself. But there are decorum limitations on that. And I thank our president for exercising those and recognizing those. Because I express and suggest that so many in this room that have talked to me in the last few minutes, there's a sincere embarrassment over the conduct of the Senate of the 53rd. And for that, on behalf of this body as the Pro Tem, to the family and friends of David Ralston, I apologize. I apologize for that conduct. I'm going to pivot now because of the story that seemed to be told by the senator from the 53rd that spoke to David Ralston as a lawyer. Most everyone has come down here and talked about David Ralston as the significant public servant in Georgia, how he served in the Senate, how he offered himself for Attorney General, how he rose with the trust of his colleagues to be the Speaker of the House for a long time. He conducted himself with honor in that way, and he also did in the way I saw him practice law. Years ago, back in the early 90s, David Ralston and I had a case against each other. I was not in politics and hadn't even thought about being in politics. But I was living and practicing law in Gainesville, and he was up in Blue Ridge. And we had a will contest case. It was one of those that's difficult because it's families against families and a will that was offered. And I saw a man that exhibited great professionalism in the way he practiced law. Even though we were against each other, and we had families that were this was very heated and very serious for the families, David Ralston conducted himself very professionally. I'll tell you one little part of the story. We had depositions that needed to be taken up in Nashville, and David and I were talking, and David and I got along because he was the consummate professional when it came to being a lawyer. And he said, John, how are you gonna get to those depositions? I said, well, I'm gonna fly up there and be there for the day. He said, that's a long way to go to drive from Gainesville to Atlanta and fly to. I said, well, no, David, I'm a pilot. I'm going to rent a plane. I'm going to fly myself up there. And he said, wow, that sounds convenient. I said, you want me to come pick you up? It was a long pause, and he said, would you do that? I said, sure. Now, you got to understand the mindset. Not every lawyer would want to do that for every other lawyer. But David Ralston behaved himself and conducted himself with that degree of decorum and professionalism that I, as opposing counsel, not only was comfortable with that, but wanted to do that. So I flew out of Gainesville, flew up to Blue Ridge, or the closest little airport to Blue Ridge, landed. David was there. He got in the plane. We flew to Nashville. And as we were going to the place for the deposition, which was in a tall building in Nashville, I said, David, we might not ought to walk in together. Maybe our clients don't need to see us walking in absolutely together. He said, you know, that's a good idea, John. So one of us walked in first, and about 5 minutes later the other did, and we went in and we had an incredibly tense deposition. Again, family matters. We fought professionally, we objected, we argued, we represented zealously our clients. And at the end of that, everyone parted ways. David and I got in a cab and drove to the airport together. I flew him from Nashville back to the airport where he was, and as we were landing, it was getting dark, and we were later than I thought we were going to be. And this was the day before everybody had a cell phone. So I pulled up and I said, David, I'm not going to shut the engine down. I want you to just hop out. I'm going to leave the engine running. I need to get out of here and get out of the mountains before it gets dark. I said, but this is my wife's phone number. would you call her as soon as you can and let her know that I'm running late, but I'm okay? Absolutely. He hops out. Everything was fine. I get home to then learn the story from my wife, who had told me that the phone rang. And she was my wife's always been nervous about me flying, like the senator's from the 19th a little bit. He flies as we have other members. But wives get nervous about us guys flying. And she said the phone rang and this deep voice said, Mrs. Kennedy. She said, yes. Susan Kennedy. Yes. Well, by this time, my wife had concluded in those 5 seconds that this was the FAA calling, that I had crashed and I was dead and she was being called to come identify the body. He said, this is David Ralston. I flew with your husband today. I'm just calling to tell you that he's going to be late, but he's going to be fine. So it ended well, but there in those moments, it certainly scared the heck out of her when David Ralston, the voice that he had, came and said that. David was a fine lawyer. He was a professional. And he was a good legislator. He was a good speaker. And he was a friend to so many of us. And I thank the majority leader for bringing this resolution. And I hope we get a nice, good vote for the family. Yes, in honoring his family. And with that, Mr. President, I yield the will.
Thank you, Senator.